Semester I did a paper on the like symbols of supernatural, and watching the sky as the sun set. The first stars would tell him when the spawn was coming through. He said, I looked up at him, but the stars just looked like stars to me. I have so much to learn. There I was in Pasadena. The boys back at the roadhouse. I wasn't being a father. I was being a hunter. I was hunting, and while I look up at the sky, I made a simple mistake. I didn't pay attention to where my feet were, and I scuffed the salt. Just a little, but enough that when something came out of the mouth of the tunnel, nothing stopped it. So there's the Key of Solomon. Is season 2 episode 6 called No Exit, which basically, if you don't watch the show, Joe is their daughter. Right there, you can't really see it. See her. Oh. But basically, they use her as like a trap for the ghost there or whatever. Straight into the devil's trap on the wall. Then he days with Sammy. Well, Dean is learning, whatever kids learn in second grade. Sammy's a very different kid. He wasn't taken to the idea of hunting bad guys, and he's still too young to really understand what that it means to avenge his mother. To him, her death just means she's not here, and he doesn't remember her. For him, Mary is a word, a mother to him. It's something he never had, but he's supposed to be sad that he died. I don't think he gets it. How could he really? October 30th. I saw an exorcism today, or something that looked like an exorcism. According to Jamis, there are really demons. I don't know if I believe that. He's a pastor, so of course he does. But demons, from hell. Even after the things I've seen in the past 3 years almost, I can't quite make demons fit. John, your wife was killed by a demon. Between watching and what happened to Bill at the Devil's Gate and what I saw today, I don't know. Jim knows that I have the journal. After he's done and the girl was looking around like someone who'd just woken up from a nightmare, you can imagine, he took me back to his church. Exorcism ritual. Usually he said you don't have to read the whole thing. Most demons can't hold out that long. But he wants me to copy the whole thing just in case. So I'm going to. I don't know if I believe in demons, but I'm not sure I can disbelieve any them anymore either. Here's the exorcism ritual. An expulsion of demon forces or an energy residing in an individual. Soul possession, command of one's motor and abilities. Oh, never mind, that wasn't. The ritual of Romanium was widely used in the mid to late 13th century in most of Eastern Europe until the church banned it. It's used in the beginning of the 14th century. Initial studies indicate that this anti-curse was helpful to get rid of individual of unwanted guest. The first part of the ritual expels entity from the host. The second half of the ritual banishes the spirit back from whence it came. Repeat the indication as followed. Now, can't read the language, so I'm not gonna even try, but I can show you it. There's the first half, and then the second half is up here. I don't know if it focuses. Sorry, it's so like dark. When I put the camera or put the light on the camera on, like the ring light, it's dark. It starts glitching. So I'm using a lamp, kind of natural lighting. On the completion of the first part of the incantation, the demon may take one or more of several forms, ranging from liquid to gaseous to corporeal to any combination of. Must be taken in performing the second part of the ritual. The demon upon expulsion can become very powerful without a need of a host. Beware that the spirit can enter through any opening of the host. Keep your eyes open and mouth shut. In Michigan, they call October 30th Devil's Night. Sammy has learned the alphabet and likes to catch bugs. She doesn't know that Dean watches his little brother like a hawk every minute with an expression on his face that says he's willing to die to keep Sammy safe. She doesn't know how it tears me up inside to see that expression and to know that it's there because I drilled it into Dean that Sammy is his responsibility. Bro. He's 8 years old, and I've told him his brother's life is in his hands. Mary, I didn't have any right to do that, but what else could I do? New Year, 1980. this one at the bottom because that's the one they use in the show. Again, I can't read Latin, so yeah. Exorcismus.
Exorcizamus te. Omnis immundus spiritus. Omnis satanica potestas. Omnis incursio infernalis adversarii. Omnis legio. Omnis congregatio. Et secta.
January 24th. Dean turns 8 today. Second grade is treating him well. I hope he can stay. He's at school and they're gonna have to have a little party for him. When he gets home, we're going to do family things. We're going to Chuck E. Cheese. And we'll eat pizza and play video games until the kids go nuts. May 2nd. Sammy is 4 today and sure enough, we're in Colorado. That's 3 out of 4 birthdays we've been visiting Daniel. The mountains are a good spot. Please suspend it early May. Maybe we should make a tradition of it. But I was having a feeling that we're not in the place, any place to start traditions. I had to pull Dean out of school when I got a note from Ellen that someone's passing through the Red House that just exercised a demon and knew where we were. I think on her skull something, a demon, when they don't know what it is. The word is easy to throw around, but whatever it is, if the one gestures were on his mind, it's an enemy. So we're moving for 2 reasons. 1, the enemy knows where we're at. 2, I'm afraid to go after him where he is. As soon as I figure that out, so we're in Colorado. On our way to Texas, Dean understands. Sammy gets Daniel's books down from the shelf and pretends to read them. He can pick out some of the words, but what he's really after is the pictures. Like any kid his age, we stopped by there because I took out a strange kind of revenant in April. One I've never seen before. It was in a Greek town, Detroit. Daniel figured out right away. I can't pronounce that word, but it was that thing. It's V-R-Y-K-O-L-A-K-A-S. Frelicus. I don't know. And then a Vedala, which is hostile spirits from Indian lore. The first one is uncorserated burial returns, either murder people in the graveyard or cause problems in the house. It's a little bit interesting. I don't think they were ever in the show that I can remember. I don't know. May 17th, this would have been our 9th anniversary. Pottery. I was 6 years iron and 9 pottery. I wonder if we would have had more children. Mary talked about a girl sometimes. I would have liked having a daughter. It's summer. We're on the move. Already I'm trying to figure out what to do with school in the fall. Figure out that you can move a kid from school to school every month and the school deals with it because they have to. A part of me wonders how the kids deal with it. But sons have soldiers and soldiers adapt. July 13th, from the month of babes. So we're in Portland, Maine, because I've heard of a Micmac sham named David Fowler who lived there. I was told him some of my story, and he agreed to raise a Manitou. And let me ask some questions. We went into the basement of his house, and he started getting the divination ready. I'm the only white man who ever sees it, he said. And he was only doing it for me for a favor of the other hunters he knew. He burned the sacred tobacco and some other herbs I didn't recognize. The room got more smoky than it seems like it should have. Manitou appeared, and I got right to the point. I asked who or what killed Mary, and then things went wrong. I still don't know whether Fowler made a mistake or whether the spirit rode up into our world along with the Manitou. Our different spirit rode up into our world with the Manitou. But whatever happened, it turned into something physical and real, like a bear, kind of. New Hampshire state line, and I told Dean a little bit what happened, because I was so frustrated and ashamed that I had to talk to someone saying he was asleep the whole time. Then Dean asked me one of those killer questions that little kids come up with. "Dad," he said, "will the Manito go after other people now?" That's our thing to face. Not that he asked the question or that he was right, but he had a better sense of right and wrong than I did.
Yeah.
We were back at Fowler's house an hour later. That night I tracked him down and killed him. He was prowling around the edges of a Cub Scout camp out in a place called Bradbury Mountain. God knows what he would have happened if Dwayne hadn't spoken up. I came close to going completely off the rails. I almost let this quest overwhelm what I know is right, and a bunch of kids almost died because of it. A hunter never passes a pond. A hunter never bails out on a hunt. That will never happen again. Never. I will not fail Mary's memory, and I will not fail the boys. So, the Micmac Jero is a winter spirit with a heart of ice created from a form from a human which wants to kill those it loves. I can't really read his handwriting, but that's what the Micmac looks like. November 2nd, Mary has been dead 4 years. Dean asked me today what she looked like. He never talks about her on any other day but this one. I couldn't even show him a picture, so I told him what you tell a boy who asks about his dead mother. I told him that she was beautiful and kind, and she loved him and Sammy more than anything in the world. So we're at 30 minutes of recording. I don't know how long this video is going to be, but that's where we're going to end it. So, if you want to hear more, make sure you subscribe, turn on the post notifications, and all that stuff. Make sure you go subscribe to my main channel where I do weekly vlogs. I post every single week. Sorry about the background noise. I'm at a college, and there's always stuff going on, so yeah. But, with that being said, I love you all so much. I hope you have a great sleep. Great day, whatever time you're watching this.